World games, yes, open world games, the Ron Seal of video gaming genres. It does exactly what it says on the tin. They're games that take place in an open world. So anyway, there are loads of open world games to choose from. You've got your Grand Theft Autos, your Saints Row, Sleeping Dogs, Just Cause. There's loads to choose from. All do different things. Some do similar things. Yeah, they all have different ideas. But now, we come onto a company that's known for doing some cool open world games, Ubisoft. They've done games like the Assassin's Creed and the Far Cry franchise as well. All the Far Cry games after Far Cry 1 when Crytek decided they didn't want to make Far Cry anymore. But anyway, who cares about that? Their newest venture into the open world genre is Watch Dogs. Yes, Watch Dogs, which is false advertising because there are no dogs of any sort in this game. That is disappointing and that is a terrible joke. I'm abandoning it. But yes, Watch Dogs. Today's latest character suffering from Ubisoft player character syndrome is douchebag, I mean bastard, I mean, wait. Oh, yeah, professional criminal slash hacker, that's what I meant, Azen Pierce, who sees something during a heist he wasn't meant to see and gets a hit put out on him. Unfortunately, he doesn't get killed by the hit, but his niece does, and he decides to swear vengeance on those responsible and figure out if he ever gets a character at some point in the game. Here's a hint, he doesn't. Yes, this is another game where we have another uninteresting main character. Really, Ubisoft, you really need to stop trying to write very good player characters because you're doing a terrible job. Assassin's Creed 3 was terrible, and Far Cry 3 had a pretty uninteresting main character. AC4 was a step in the right direction with Edward Kenway, and now we're back to this, really. Agent Pierce is a very unsympathetic character. I mean, he steals money from people who deserve it. I mean, that's not cool, man. You can't do that. God. So it's very hard to sympathize with his quest for vengeance. And he's just, yeah, he's just unsympathetic and all that. Plus, the side characters are way more interesting than he is, especially the fixer he hires to help him, Geordie Chin. But anyway, the game also has a very inconsistent tone with its story. It can't decide if it wants to be a serious story or a story with colourful characters, sort of like the GTA games. So it's confused and, yeah, it's poorly written and, yeah, it's terrible. The story is awful. I don't like it. So yeah, and also the ending is basing for a sequel. Why, Ubisoft? Why? Here's a hint, you want to make sure your game's set. Oh, wait, the pre-orders for this game were incredible. Crap, alright, fair enough. I guess, you know, they were guaranteed to make a sequel. Anyway, gameplay-wise, the gameplay at least fares way better than the story. It's good, it's fun. Let's start with the driving. The driving's alright. Some people take issue with the driving because it's really loose, but hey, it's still better than GTA 4, right? Oh god, don't remind me of GTA 4's driving. Anyway, but I think the driving's really elevated by the chase sequences and the hacking. Yes, the hacking really makes some of the chases you get into really fun. Because you can hack traffic lights, and you can hack traffic bollards. Oh my god, it's satisfying to see one of your enemies just go flying into a traffic bollard. Oh god, I could watch that for ages. It's so funny. But anyway, the driving's quite fun, and the hacking really brings it up. The shooting's also really good in the game. It's got a really good cover system, which allows you to go from cover to cover with one simple button press. You can also round corners, no problem. Plus, you can carry all the weapons in the goddamn game, which is great. I love games that do this because I want to be able to be ready for any situation possible. I'm not a big fan of weapon limits, so I'm glad to see that Watch Dogs does away with this. And you'll need all those weapons, because this game can be quite difficult. The AI is pretty accurate, and they'll sometimes actually even send armored units after you, and my god, they will ruin your day, those armored units. Oh yeah, they will ruin your day. So the shooting's really good, and plus you can use your hacking to have some interesting combat elements, like detonating a grenade that's on someone. That's also quite cool. And some other stuff, including stopping your enemies from calling reinforcements. It's all really nice. The game also has some stealth. At times in the game, you'll go into either these CTOS centers or these gang hideouts, and you can choose to stealth these. Now, with the CTOS centers, you can actually rise the security cameras. This is one of the more interesting systems in Watch Dogs, where you can basically hack into a security camera and then use these to sort of hack your way around the area without actually having to go in. Now, the thing with these CTOS centers is you have to find an access code and then you have to hack in through the security thing. So you can just basically ride the cameras. It's really cool. Sometimes even security guards will actually have cameras on them. It's a really cool idea and I love the camera system. It's very handy too for some of the environmental puzzles during some of the side activities. So it's a really, really cool idea and I approve. Thanks, Ubisoft. But the stealth itself is really basic. You can use silenced weapons to take out your enemies or melee takedowns. You can't really hide bodies or drag them. You can also use traps. You can explode junction boxes. You can drop crates on top of people. That sort of thing. So you do have an element of strategy in there as well, I suppose. If technically. But yeah, stealthing is a good idea as well sometimes. Then we come to the hacking. Now, if you've heard already... The hacking's pretty simple. You just basically aim when a notification comes up that you can hack something, you hold down the square button and you hack it. You have a battery meter at the bottom left corner of your screen, and depending on hacks you use, it'll take up your battery meter. So once you use certain hacks, it will actually drain your battery life and you can't use that until your battery recharges. And I guess this makes sense. You don't want to overuse your hacks, so it's cool. I like that. Plus you can always upgrade your hacks to get a bigger battery life, so that's kind of cool. But the hacks are pretty easy. You can do sometimes though you'll have to hack in through this special security thing, which will instigate this sort of hacking mini game where you have to sort of guide these data links so that you can unlock the top tier and then basically breach the security. It's actually pretty hard to explain without actually playing it for yourself. So you'll know what I mean if you actually do play this game. So yeah. But the hacking is really cool. It really adds a lot of new fun elements to the shooting and the driving and the stealth. I mean, normally if the hacking element wasn't there, this game would be a pretty average open world game, but these really elevate it from being that into being a really fun open world game. You can also craft items, which I was really surprised to see. You'll gather these sort of craftable items during the game, and you can use these to craft certain hacks like Blackout, which blacks out an entire city block, which is always fun to use. There's jam communications. You can jam CTOS scans, and you can also jam people's phone calls, which is also a pretty cool hack to use. There's loads to do to craft. It's a cool system. There's also a progression system in Watch Dogs. You can upgrade your hacking, your shooting, your driving, your craftable items. So you can customize your character to the way you like him. But of course, you'll end up getting all the hacks anyway if you pretty much do everything in the game. So forget what I just said. But one of the cooler things in Watch Dogs are the digital trips. Now, these are sort of minier games inside the game. There's four of them. Well, there's a fifth one if you buy the season pass. God damn you, Ubisoft! But the four that you do get with the game are Madness, a sort of Ghost Rider-esque game where you basically drive this flaming car and you run over mutants. It's kind of weird. They're all kind of weird. Alone is this sort of survival horror-esque thing where the city, there's a version of Chicago's been taken over by robots, and you have to light up these city districts by hacking these lights to get rid of them. It's actually surprisingly difficult because the robots are pretty tough once they spot you. This is one where you have to really stealth it. Then there's a spider tank, which is pretty self-explanatory. You cause chaos in a spider tank, and my god, is it so fun! I love it! Just causing chaos in a spider tank, it's so fun! God, I love it. And then there's Psychedelic, which is basically basically is a virtual version of an LSD trip. Basically, these giant flowers start... you're flying through the air and bouncing on these giant flowers all through Chicago. It's really weird, but it's really awesome. And it's probably my personal favorite because of how ridiculous it is. These digital trips are one of the many reasons why Watch Dogs is better than it is kind of cool. It's cool that Ubisoft actually put these in there, despite not including the fifth one because Season Pass and extra money, yo! God damn you, Ubisoft! But it's still cool that they included the four anyway, and I really enjoy them. They're actually... you'll actually spend hours playing them as well. They're pretty addicting. Also, there's a lot of side activities in Watch Dogs. You got your privacy invasions, you got your criminal convoys, you got your fixer contracts, because the only way to stop crime is by causing more crime, am I right? Am I right? And since you're a vigilante, you'll actually have to stop crimes at times. Now, this seems like a really cool idea. At times during the game, you'll get a signal that a crime's been detected in the area. You'll go to the area where the crime's about to happen, and you basically have to either detect the victim or the criminal. Once you detect the criminal or the victim, you basically have to either watch or tail that person to see what happens, and then then you have to intervene at the right time in order to stop the criminal. Now, this system was cool, only that it's kind of ruined by the fact that, how do I put this? They never really change the outcome of most of these crimes. Either someone is getting held up, either someone drunk is hassling someone, or a jealous ex-boyfriend is hassling a woman. This is the exact same every single time. So it kind of sucks. The only purpose for these criminal crime detection things, is to do up your reputation. You've got a reputation system in this game. Since you're a vigilante, if you have a very low reputation, i.e. a negative, people will see you, you'll have more news reports about you, and people will call the cops on you pretty much whenever they see you. If you've a high one, people will say how much of a great person you are, and won't call the cops on you as much. So yeah, there's that. It's not a really well thought out system, if I'm honest with you. It's a cool idea, but it's not a great system. So yeah, but there's plenty to do here. Also, did I mention the multiplayer? Yes, if there's one thing that Ubisoft have been harking on about this game, is the fact that you can seamlessly go into another person's game and hack them. And yes, it is cool. It does work. It's actually pretty satisfying. I'm just not very good at it. Basically, the idea is you hack into someone else's game, you basically find them, you hack them, and then you have to try and not get spotted while staying in the area where you're hacking them. It's pretty tense, and when they spot you, you then have to escape. It's pretty tense, not gonna lie. It's really, really tense. There's also a tailing mode, there's also a free-roam mode, there's a deathmatch variant, and there's some racing. So there's something for everyone here if you're not into the whole hacking thing. I do actually enjoy doing the racing, if I'm honest with you. That's actually pretty fun, but mostly because I'm good at the driving, so maybe that's just me being biased. But yeah, the multiplayer is really good. So overall, there's a lot to do here, and the gameplay is pretty fun. Now, how about the graphics? Well, the game doesn't look amazing. It looks alright. I mean, it's got some really nice rain effects, and the way they designed Chicago is pretty good. It feels realistic. It doesn't feel too crazy. And plus, you know, the game has some nice lighting. But other than that, textures are okay, and the character models are alright. This game doesn't look amazing, you know? It looks alright. It gets the job done, you know? Certainly not the game we saw 2 years ago at E3, that's for sure. Sound-wise, the game has some decent voice acting, except for the main voice actor, the guy who does Aiden, really is trying to do his best Christian Bale impression. He sounds like he's trying to do it too much, but he's alright, and the rest of the voice acting is pretty good. The game has a really nice ambient soundtrack and a really good licensed soundtrack, which I approve that you get to choose what music you want to play. There's no radio station, so you can just skip songs and listen to songs to your heart's content. I approve of this. I like to be able to choose my own what music I want to listen to. So thanks for that, Ubisoft. Performance-wise, it runs at 1080p. Well, not really 1080p. It runs at 900p upscale to 1080, so it's not native true 1080p. It's 30 frames per second. Yeah, it runs at 30 frames per second, and it runs at 30 FPS constant. It never drops down. Also, bug-wise, there's not really many bugs. There's a few glitches. The game crashed on me once. I once lost my save. But other than that, it was fine. What else? Oh, yes. Value for money. Yep, this game is very good value for money. You're getting a lot of content here for your bucks. So there's a good amount of content here for your money. It's 75 euro at the moment. It's a bit expensive, but I think it's worth it. I've had a lot of fun with it, and there's a lot here to do. So overall, Watch Dogs is a really, really fun game. It's definitely not the game that was promised, and it doesn't look like the game we saw 2 years ago, but it's still really fun and has a lot to like about it. The story is pretty bad, but despite that, it's got really fun gameplay, and the hacking really does bring this game up. I think Watch Dogs is one of the more fun open-world games I've played in recent years, and you should definitely give it a try. I give Watch Dogs a 9 out of 10. Well, guys, that's going to cut it for Watch Dogs. I'd like to thank you for watching my review, and as always, you can follow me on Twitter. The link's in the description if you want to follow me. And sorry about how the way I stopped there in sort of the middle of talking about the performance. I heard a really loud noise, and I just like, oh my god, what the hell was that? So, yeah. But thanks for watching, and this will be my last review for a while. I'm sorry to say that there's nothing else coming out for a really good while, so... But I will try to do some more stuff. A friend of mine's actually asked me to do some gameplay. This PS1 game I'll be getting in soon. So I'll do that. There'll be that. And I hope to get back into Let's Playing soon. So I'll be definitely posting more news about that. But otherwise, other than that, I hope you guys have a really good day. Take very good care. And as always, thank you for watching and thank you for supporting. Also, I'm very close to 100 subscribers. I really want to push for it. We're about three or a three away, I think. Yeah, we're three away. So if you could share my channel around, I really want to get to 100. We can do this, guys. Thank you very much. I really appreciate your support. Thanks, guys, and I'll see you later.